Welcome back, students. In this lecture, I'm going to show you an interface of Google Earth Engine. Essentially, Google Earth Engine is a website that you can access through your web browser. So for this, you have to type in this address, earthengine.google.com, or you can just simply go to the Google and type Earth Engine. Yeah, then the first thing which will come up will be the link to the website of Google Earth Engine. So what exactly Google Earth Engine is? Earth Engine is a platform for scientific analysis and visualization of geospatial data set for academic, non-profit, business and government users. Earth Engine hosts satellite imagery and stores it in a public data archive that includes historical Earth images going back more than 40 years. The images ingested on a daily basis are then made available for global scale data mining. So basically, Google Earth Engine and its creation became a game changer in the way how we use and how we perform geospatial analysis. So beforehand, we were doing the geospatial analysis mostly on our desktop computers, where we use, for example, ArcGIS, QGIS, and where we would do analysis on one image, multiple images, or time series, but for certain limited areas. But with the Google Earth Engine, it is now possible to do it on a global scale. So basically, scale now is not a limitation anymore. So we can also run analysis in Google Earth Engine for the whole planet, which previously would require really an enormous server computation power that nowadays is not needed if you use Google Earth Engine. Well, what is also interesting there, Google Earth Engine actually offers APIs in both Python and JavaScript. So those are code editing editor environment where we can actually with the help of the codes that you have to write by yourself or you have to search for them, can do different special geospatial analysis, including remote sensing and GIS analysis. And this is how code editor looks like, but I'm going to talk about it also in detail. And of course, there are different already case studies, and the number of applications of Google Earth Engine is enormous, and it's very popular nowadays cloud computing environment for geospatial analysis. What is interesting for you? Well, basically, there is frequently asked questions that you can look through in by your own, but there is also time lapse. This is a kind of window where you can see different changes based on their computed, based on, I think, Landsat data. For example, we can here zoom in to Istanbul area. Yeah, who knows, this is Istanbul metropolitan area like this. And the core of the historical Istanbul is located here on the right, on the European part. We can go, for example, back to 40 years time, and let's say we will start, let's go to the minimum 1984, and we can start with animations, and then you could see how the area was changing. Yeah, we actually, what we really can see, what is a really nice example, we can see how Istanbul was growing and became one of the mega cities of our planet. Well, there are also some case studies that I encourage you to look at. It's also very interesting because some of these case studies are really made a big impact on scientific community and remote sensing and environmental analysis. So Global Forest Cover Change by Matt Hansen was released in 2013. There is also a Global Forest Watch implementation with the help of Google Earth Engine and other interesting case studies, which could make you inspired. Then we have platform. This is basically what will be really interesting for us, and we are going to work with this menu quite a lot. So if you are serious about getting proficient in Google Earth Engine, this is the page which are going to be one of your main addresses for the next weeks. And what is really I can suggest to you to look at the documentation tab here, platform documentation. Here you would find a very thoroughly designed and step-by-step documentation for Google Earth Engine. So for sure, after completing my course, you would be up and running with the basic skills which are needed to do geospatial analysis. But in order to go beyond what we will learn here in this course, you would definitely will consult this page not once. And there is also an access to code editor and as well as to Explorer. So there is difference between code editor and Google Earth Engine Explorer. In Google Earth Engine Explorer, you can do in a quite an easy and software like manner machine learning. You can apply machine learning analysis for different geospatial problems based on remote sensing imagery. And for this, I have a special video on this, and I'm going to provide you with this video later in this course. So and code editor is their API which we are going to work with you quite a lot. I mean, most of this course is going to be about it. So the next video is going to explain the interface of code editor. So this is basically API where we can write and edit our code to perform specific geospatial analysis. Then there is a blog that you can read about Google Earth Engine with different interesting, exciting news. And finally, there is a very important link for you, is the link for sign up. How to sign up to Google Earth Engine, I'm going to explain you in the next video.